Boker Tov, Chavrim. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. It's going to be a whirlwind of news today and prophetic insights coming out of Israel and also other parts of the Middle East there. For our first story topping this morning, breaking police have recommended an indictment for Prime Minister Netanyahu. And as we've stated here on Israeli News Live, our own source there that we did reveal, Roger Stone, saying at a private luncheon there that the Prime Minister would resign on Monday. Now, we don't know where he got his source from, how he obtained that information, but we know there's been a lot of allegations coming out that the police would indict the Prime Minister. We also stated that we didn't think that it was a wise decision at this time, especially with the transition, any type of smooth transition with all the troubles that Israel is under with its neighbors, Syria, Lebanon, and even Iran, especially after the latest strike where Prime Minister Netanyahu retaliated for the downing of the F-16, taking out 12 targets inside of Syria, four of those being Iranian and eight of those being that of the Syrian government, its air defense systems around Damascus. So it is a troubling situation. And of course, right now the HaAretz has came out just moments ago. Israel police recommend charging Prime Minister Netanyahu with bribery in two cases. They call those cases 1,000, 2,000, and even 3,000. Those are just alleged case numbers, not the real numbers themselves. And they said their investigation was ready on the first two cases, which, of course, one of those is the alleging that Netanyahu received lavish gifts from wealthy businessmen in return for political favors. Also, number 2000, which is the Israeli police will recommend indicting Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu in two corruption investigations. The second one being, which alleges that Netanyahu tried to strike a deal that would have provided him with positive coverage in Israel's second largest newspaper, Yedioth Aharonot, in exchange for hurting its free rival, Israel Hayom, which translates out today or the day, Israel the day. The trouble is also is that one of Prime Minister Netanyahu's former aides there has also worked out a deal with other charges against him for bribery of testifying against the Prime Minister. This is something that will not go over very well. And of course, on top of that, the Times of Israel is reporting a smiling Rivlin, that's President Rivlin of Israel, hence he believes Netanyahu should resign if indicted. Longtime benefactor Sheldon Adelson asked by journalists whether he hopes Prime Minister will emerge unscathed, declines to defend Netanyahu. It's a very troubling situation. And then we also have Naftali Bennett, the MK member who also has aspirations of being Israel's next prime minister, Arut Sheva. That's Israel's national news, comes out with this article here. Bennett, we will lead the government when Netanyahu's time is up. Now, this just came out. Education Minister Bennett says the government won't collapse. No reason to hold elections over police recommendations. I thought it was kind of interesting. So having a connection with Bennett there, we reached out to his office there. And today we got this response back after only about an hour of our response going out. Naftali Bennett's secretary responded, there are various scenarios depending on the police recommendation. Resigning is one of them. That said, Minister Bennett has already been asked and replied to questions on the matter. And of course, the resignation is that of Prime Minister Netanyahu. Then we also have another article that just came out as well. That's very concerning. Came out today, Israel Today. In fact, the very paper that it seems like that Netanyahu was against publishes this article, Israel abuzz after Netanyahu gets slapped in the face from Trump. Now that was a troubling article itself. And in the actual, the real depth of the article, it says here, but on Monday, Trump called Netanyahu a liar, or so reported Israel's major newspapers. Now, President Trump didn't actually call Netanyahu a liar, and I don't know if it was actually directly with President Trump or not, but they were saying the reports were false. This is what the article states here. Speaking to members of the Likud party, Netanyahu stated that for some time now, he had been discussing with the Trump White House his government's intention to apply Israel's civil law to the Jewish settlements in Judea and Samaria. The so-called sovereignty law is reported by many as nothing less than the annexation of territories claimed by the Palestinians. In other words, Netanyahu suggested that Trump had been conferring and Israel's possible annexation of the West Bank. The White House immediately fired back with spokesman Josh Raphael telling reporters, reports that the United States discussed with Israel an annexation plan for the West Bank are false. The United States and Israel have never discussed such proposals, and the president's focus remains squarely on his Israel-Palestinian peace initiative. And in fact, many of the Israeli newspapers actually published the translation of that quote as he lied. Very troubling indeed, the things that we are seeing that are coming out. And again, we do not believe that a rash resignation would be the wisest thing for Israel. If there were to be a resignation, we think that it should be done with dignity, and that also should be done with Israel's security very much in mind. I'm Stephen Benoon. Be watching more today, more news coverage, prophetic insights, some very powerful things that we want to share with you. You do need to check out DeNoon Institute, our YouTube channel there. Some very provocative information going to be coming out there, revelations, insights as well, and I know you're not going to want to miss it. If you like the broadcast, if you appreciate the coverage we bring, we know that a lot of times it's things that are very troubling, but we try to tell you the truth. We try to stand what we believe is truly the correct way of dealing with things. And if you support this type of work, stand with us and support this work. We do need your help in doing so. I'm Stephen Benoon with Israeli News Live. Shalom.